Hello, my name is Hamid. I'm a Cisco instructor at ASM Educational Center. Today I'm going to talk about static route and default route. That is, the goal is that the PC number one right here seated at here, I want to make sure he can ping PC number four. Now if I go to command prompt, I type in, let me close this, type in ipconfig. I see my PC address is 10.10.10.1, default gives 10.10.200. This network's network 10 is, this is network 30.4/30/30, as you know that from IP addressing, means I need only two IP address, and this is block size of four, two value IPS. So this IPS will be .5, this is .6, and this network, network 20 is, okay? So when I go to PC and I ping this PC, PC4, 20.20.20.4, see, it's a destination host is unreachable. So that's a problem, so we want to solve that. So what happened, it goes up to router, but it get dropped. But let's look at the router right now. What do we have? If I go to router one, if I type in show IP and debrief, I see I have two interface. 10.10.10.100, that's my F00. And then I have Syria 30.30.5. So this side is 30.30.5. If you notice that I'm using 30.30.4/30. .4 is a subnet ID. /30 means what? 255.255.255.252. And that subnet mask means you're gonna have a forward valid IPF block of size of 4 and two value IPS. Now if this is .4 is, this side has to be .5 and this has to be .6. So let's go back again, check here. So I'm at the router right now. I wanna make sure I can ping the other side. Ping 30.30.30.6. So I see I have connected from router one to router two, okay? But again, I cannot ping from PC one to PC4. Why is that? Because in order that any network talk to each other network, you have to be inside the routing table. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to look at the routing table. There's a command is show IP route. Now before I do this, now notice that according to this, I have two connected. I have network 10.10.10 and 30, okay? So when I say show IP route, by default I should see two connected. C means what? Connected. Again, I see network 10 because that's this side, and then I see network 30. That's on what? Router what? One. So you see that router one does not see network what? 20. In order to see network 20, what I have to do, I have to put inside my routing table. Now there's two ways you can do that. You can do a static route, which we're gonna cover that, and dynamic routing. Dynamic routing we're gonna cover later on. That's gonna be OSPF, ERGRP and so on. So let's go to router 2 also. Let's see what we have router 2. First I say show IP and debrief, and I see that here I have 20.20.100, that's this other router, and then I have 30.30.6, that's this other router, okay? And so how do I solve the problem? I'm gonna use static route. Now the way it started right here, I have in my notes right here, I'm going to show you that right now. I have in my notes, you need to put destination network inside my routing table. How do you do that? You're going to say config T, then you're going to say IP route, question mark. Here, you have to put destination that you want to get in. Then you put a question mark, you put a subnet mask, question mark, they need next hub address. In this case, will be 30.30.6. So let's look at the diagram. Right now, I'm a router one right now, okay? The goal is, when I finish that, I'm gonna have a network 20 in my network. So how do I do that? I have to do static route. So I'm gonna say like this, config T, IP route question mark. Again, see destination network. Where do I want to go? I want to go what network? Network 20. So I'm going to put 20.20.20.0 question mark. The key is always use a question. What I need? I need destination prefix max. And that will be 255.255.255.0. Because that's what that is right now, /24 right here. Question mark. Space question mark. Then I need what? The 401 IP address, or I can use my own interface, okay? So what I'm gonna do in this scenario, I'm gonna use 401 IP address. I'm a router one right now. See, I'm a router one. I'm right here. The next hop will be what right here? This number, which is dot what? 6. So this, the forward address in here is gonna be what? 30.30.30.6, okay? Control Z, always typing show run to check your work. When I go down, you can see all of at the bottom, here's my static route. Again, IP route, on exam, anytime you see this, that's the destination IPS you wanna get, and that's the next hop is right here, okay? Now I try that, show IP route, check the routing table. I see a S, S means what here? Static. O means what? OSPF. C means connected. See, this is a C connected. I'm connected network 10. Directly connect to F00 right here. And also network what? 30, which is directly on serial. So I see it. I put a static route here, okay? Now let's see if PC1 can ping that. Let's try again. I use the up arrow key. I see I cannot ping. Why is that? Because ping is echo and echo reply. That means PC1 knows how to get here. But this router does not know how to get back. If I say show IP route, I'm a router 2 right now. I'm connecting network 20 and network 30. Show IP route. See, I see network 20 and network 30. I do not see network 10. So whatever I did on router 1, I have to do on router 2 again. So the key is, remember that whenever you do a static route, you have to do all routers. You cannot just do one routers. So what I'm gonna say config T. The key is put network 10 inside the routing table. So I'm gonna say IP route question mark. What I need? Destination address. Destination address will be what? Right here. 10.10.10.0 question mark. I need the prefix, destination prefix, which will be /24 subnet mask, 255.255.255.0 question mark. Then I need a, I can use the next IP address, which will be what right here, 3030.5, or I can use my own interface. Now here, I'm just gonna use my own interface, which is what, S00, S030. So it doesn't matter what I use, S03/0. Okay, so Control Z, show run. You always check a show run. Now you see that? I'm a router what? 2 right now. It's an IP route, this is destination network, always destination network, remember that? And that's my own IP address. Now if I say show IP route, I will see network 10 as what? Static route. Yeah, took 20 and 30, okay? So right now life is good. Now I'll go back to PC1 and try ping again. And voila, it's working. Why is working? Because the packet goes all over to here. First gonna check the routing table, then goes right here, comes back. As it's coming back, because remember ping is echo and echo reply, as it's coming back, this router knows how to get back to here. So to summarize what you need, you have to do everything about each router, okay? So that was a good summary of the static route. I just want to show you that we offer these classes free of charge for you and for your friends. I highly recommend that if you need more training or anything like that, you can check our website. Our website is right here, asmed.com. On the top, I just want to show you something. We have a Google Plus, we have a Pinterest, and also we have a Twitter account and everything. If you go to the Google Plus, that take you to our page. We have a page here. We have a CCNA, CCNP like that. If you click on the CCNA training, you're gonna see a bunch of video. The video we put here, we put a bunch of tips here. So my recommendation, make sure you go to our social media and watch this. And also, if you go back to our homepage, when you go back to here, right here at the homepage, at the bottom of the page, we have something called IT courses. If you click that, that take you IT technology. We offer CompTIA, Microsoft, A+, Netoplus, CQ+, all of that Microsoft courses. And also we offer different Cisco classes like CCNA right here. If you click here, you have different formats. You have bootcamp, you have evening, you have online classes, we have bootcamp WebEx, and we have evening WebEx. What that means, online is a self-study, so that you just do self-study. The bootcamp is live, but if you're far away, you can do it through WebEx. So I just want to show you that these are the tools available from you. Again, we appreciate for your time and effort. And again, thank you so much. And try to remember that always practice. You have a good day. Bye-bye.